Hi everyone, Jared here from Email Experts. We help e-commerce brands grow via email and automated marketing. And in this video, I'm going to go over how you can recover lost sales with an abandoned cart flow. So the abandoned cart flow is a series of emails that are triggered when someone has not completed their purchase via the checkout. In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up an abandoned cart recovery flow for your Shopify or BigCommerce store using Klaviyo. And it should work for other platforms too. The goal of this flow is to get the customer to return to finish their purchase. The abandoned cart flow is effective in bringing the customer back because the contents of their cart are populated into the email, making it quick and easy for them to complete their purchase with a click of a button. And we really don't want to leave money on the table. So let's jump into Klaviyo. First things first, before you set up the abandoned cart flow, you want to connect your Klaviyo account to your e-commerce platform. Within Klaviyo, go to Integrations on the left and connect to your store. When you connect it, Klaviyo will add a lot of great features to your account, including pre-populating your flow library. So now, since we have integrated our store and our Klaviyo account, let's go and create the flows. So at Email Experts, we recommend starting with Klaviyo's default abandoned cart flow. So you want to go to Flows and click on Create a Flow. You want to choose a standard abandoned cart flow. This creates a placeholder flow and it should work exactly as you expect. Once a customer abandons, the email will be sent to the customer with the products populated and linked to the cart. So now I'm going to go over how this flow works. So Klaviyo tracks events happening on your site and calls them metrics. So when someone starts a checkout, they trigger the started checkout metric. And when they place an order, it triggers the placed order metric. These and other metrics are what makes Klaviyo's flows and segments so powerful. So the abandoned cart is sent to anyone who starts checkout but doesn't place an order, or in Klaviyo's terms, they place an order 0 times since starting this flow. As a flow filter, this filter is checked every single time before an email is sent, ensuring customers stop receiving the abandoned cart as soon as they complete a checkout. What's more, the metadata in the metric can also populate the contents of the email, which is how the contents of the cart are populated into the email. Luckily, you don't need to worry anything about the technicalities, since Klaviyo has already set up the rules and built the placeholder email for you. So now it's time to build your first email. So now we are in the Klaviyo email builder. And when you open up this email, you will see some code, also called merge tags, that might look a little bit strange, but this is the code that will be replaced with the contents of the cart the customer abandoned. You can see that over here. On the left tab, you can click Preview, and let's show it within Klaviyo, and you can see what someone has abandoned. If this is a new store, and if you don't have metrics triggered yet, you won't see anything. So I would recommend you to go into your store, abandon the checkout, so you can populate them within Klaviyo. You can now edit the styling, but don't edit the code of the block or the content in the cart might not work. Now it's time to edit the email to make it match your brand. Now the email is designed as I want it, and let's check it by previewing it here. Perfect. So now since we've built the first email, let's go and build the rest. And rather than editing each email, you can just duplicate this new beautiful email that you have just made and drag it into a new place, rename it, and delete the old placeholder content. Then you can edit each email based on the message and still show the cart contents. So I'm going to add, let's say, a 1-day delay in between these emails. And I'll put the new email over here. In Klaviyo, you can also add splits into flows, including the abandoned cart flows. I will demo two types here. The first type is by splitting between first time and returning customers. To do that, we will add a conditional split, and let's set up the rules of has placed order 0 times over all time. So customers who go down this path will be first time customers, and the rest of them will be returning customers. This way, you can offer a discount code to first time abandoners without giving one to returning customers, preventing returning customers from gaming your abandoned cart flow for discounts. To learn how to add an auto-apply discount code in your abandoned cart email, watch our other video on how to do that. I'll add a card above, or you can find the link in the description below. Alternatively, you may want to split it by country or state to showcase different shipping policies. To do this, edit your split to properties about someone, change it to country, is in, and then select the countries you want in your split. As I said, this can be a great way of promoting your shipping policies. There are other ways to split your abandoned cart flow for different strategic purposes, such as splitting the flow based on the products in their cart, high or low value cards, or assumed gender of the customer based on their name. If you have a particular split you want to try, ask a question in the comments below and we'll help you out. And while you're there, don't forget to like and smash the subscribe button. Now that the emails are designed, we're nearly ready to activate the flows. But before we do, make sure that any existing abandoned cart emails in your e-commerce platform are turned off so the customers don't receive two batches. I'll show you how to do it in Shopify, but you should check your own e-commerce platform since it might send abandoned cart emails too. So right now, as you can see in my Shopify account, you want to head on to settings, notification settings, abandoned cart settings, and turn them off. Now we're ready to turn it on in Klaviyo. To do so, go into your flow and switch all the flows from draft to live. Now Klaviyo will start sending as soon as people abandon their cart. I recommend that you abandon your cart on your store once, just so you can make sure that it is working properly. And with that being said, this concludes the end of this video on how to set up an abandoned cart flow. I hope you found this useful. If you did, I would really appreciate if you could smash the like button and hit the subscribe button. We post videos every 3 weeks, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. We might turn them into a future video. Thank you very much, and I'll see you again.